In Illustrator, as you create all kinds of different projects for print, mobile, and web, you'll need to edit artboards. Maybe copying an artboard to make a new version of existing artwork, or resizing an artboard to match print specifications. In this video, you'll learn how to edit existing artboards and then duplicate an artboard. You can open this file from the practice files for this tutorial if you'd like to follow along. To make sure that you can see everything in the document, choose View, Fit All in Window. To start, select the artboard tool in the Tools panel on the left. You can see the different artboards in the document, indicated by the name in the corner of each and the dotted box around the active or selected artboard. Suppose you need to resize an artboard, maybe to match a paper size on your desktop printer. Click in the first artboard with the green background if it isn't already selected. You can tell it's selected because of the dotted box and handles surrounding it. Now to resize it, move the pointer over the bottom edge and drag when you see arrows. As you drag, you'll see a width and height in the gray label next to the pointer. This is a part of Smart Guides. When it's about the size you see here, release the mouse button. Notice that the artboard changed in size while the artwork stayed the same. You can also set an artboard to a preset size. With the artboard still selected, click the preset option in the Properties panel to the right, and in this case, choose Letter. Move the pointer into the artboard and drag it up, aligning it as best you can to the artboard to the right. Notice that as you drag the artboard, the artwork moves with it, but you still need to move and resize this artwork to fit better on the artboard. To do that, you'll stop editing the artboards. So click the Exit button at the top of the Properties panel. With the selection tool selected, drag across the artwork on this artboard to select it. Then drag it down, roughly into the center of the artboard. To deselect everything, click in a blank area. You still need to resize the green rectangle to fit the artboard. So click the green rectangle to select it, press and hold the Option key on Mac or the Alt key on Windows, and drag the middle point on the bottom of the shape down to make the shape as large as the artboard. When it's the right size, release the mouse button and then the key. Pressing the Option or Alt key resizes the artwork from the center. Click in a blank area to deselect it. You can also duplicate artboards, maybe to make a version of a design with a different color background. Select the Artboard tool in the Tools panel on the left, then press the Option key on Mac or Alt key on Windows, and with the pointer over the artboard, click and drag down to make a copy. When it's in place here, release the mouse button and then the key. To see all of the artboards again, choose View, Fit All in Window. With the new artboard selected, in the Properties panel to the right of the document, change the name to Letterhead 2. Press Return or Enter to make the change. To stop editing artboards, click the Exit button at the top of the Properties panel. Now you'll edit the artwork on the new artboard. So with the selection tool selected, click the green background shape on the new artboard. To change the color, click the Fill Color in the Properties panel, make sure the swatches are selected, and select an orange color. Being able to edit artboards, whether by resizing them, duplicating them, changing artboard options, or other, gives you creative flexibility to design all kinds of different projects in Illustrator.